YouTube, I'm here to talk to you and to talk to the industry, the game industry, especially Xbox and Sony PlayStation. I am a gamer like yourself, and I have a problem that most of the gamers will probably understand and also know what I'm talking about. First of all, let me start off by saying that I have cerebral palsy, ICP, which in a nutshell affects my muscles to the point where they have a mind of their own, but I am able to control my right arm to function, to do everything that I need to do in my day in, day out life. But as a gamer, it can be a tough situation. Let me explain. When I first started out gaming, of course, most of your controllers were just maybe two or three buttons. Well, of course, if you use Atari, it's one button and a joystick. But as the consoles and the gaming industry progressed, the controllers became more advanced. But they use two buttons to three buttons. And I'm talking about Nintendo, Sega. And a lot of the games, you really didn't have a lot of button mashing to do, so you were able to control it. But then when you got to like the PS2, an Xbox, that's when your controllers use every button on the controller itself. Here I have a controller that most of you may recognize. You used it on the PS2, and it was called the Storm Chaser, made by Interact. And the beauty of this controller was, and is that, as you can see, it has six face buttons. And then you have your normal four shoulder buttons. But the cool thing about it is, with this, you are programmable. And rapid fire. So, say like if you wanted to take if you're playing Halo or something, and you wanted to take the trigger button, which is the far right R2 button, you could take that and put it up here on the square button, or the X button if you're playing with the Xbox, which is pretty cool. So you could change all the buttons around. Now, here's the problem. When I got an Xbox, I couldn't control the Xbox, the original Xbox, kind of looked like this controller. It didn't. A little bit bigger. And if you imagine, it'd be kind of hard for someone with one hand to play this, like Halo and stuff, because of the setup on his controller. Luckily, I did some searches on the internet, and I found a device like this that I could hook into my, I get my PS2 Sony Tracer controller into, and put the USB in there, and it will also plug into an Xbox. When I moved the Xbox from Sony PlayStation, I was very excited that I found that I could play on Xbox. Now don't get me wrong, I still play Sony PlayStation and Xbox, but I'm more of an Xbox fan now. When the 360 came out, luckily, the device, and as you can see, I know I got a G-Rig right now. I have a USB adapter, and the reason for this is because with the 360, it's hard to plug the device into the slot, if you know what I mean. Even when you use a regular Xbox 360 control, it's very hard to get to the USB port. But I digress. So luckily, I'm able to use my Xbox 360 with my unique setup. Now there's a catch. As you know, we go through cycles with consoles. To every 10 to 15 years, it seems like. Or 8 to 10 years. Don't quote me on that, but when the Xbox One came out, and I learned that it was USB, I was like, yes, great, I could use my setup on the Xbox One. Well, lo and behold, I tried it, and it won't recognize it. So basically, I'm sitting with the $600 Day One Xbox One paperweight that I use as for my Netflix, because I cannot get my setup to work. Well, I'm here to ask and talk to the companies, because I even looked for PlayStation 4 and it still wouldn't work. And I do not have one, but I checked around with friends. And so since they did these new controllers, the port will not recognize my setup. I'm here to demonstrate, and for not just myself, but for other individuals that I had to play with one hand, especially two or three fingers, that the game developer either needs to come up with a six button face controller, kind of like this, that's programmable, that you can program all the buttons. And what I mean by all the buttons is, I'm saying X, but it's square, But since I got it on Xbox BX, and I could put it on the right D-pad and still use it. So it needs to be that advanced to program. It'd be great if they either come out with a controller that they still got all the Xbox One features, but just, I know it's a little big, but some people might like to use one like this. And I even talk about people who are not physically disabled could still use this and get a kick out of this. So let me show you a little bit of what I'm talking about. Okay. First we're going to play Watch Dogs on the Xbox 360. So let me get it going. Sorry for that. It got updated, of course. While it's updating, let me just tell you, as you play Watch Dogs on Xbox One or the computer or whatever you have, you will know that you got the A button. The X button is to do the phone, do your hacks. You got the right trigger button to shoot. You got the trigger button to aim. The left trigger button to aim. Your B to do takedowns. Y is basically jump in and jump out of cars. You have the up button on D-pad to do the bring up your phone apps so you can go through it. The right D-pad to circle through music. Now imagine me trying to do all that on here. There's no way. So let me show you what I work with and how I play games with this controller and just using two fingers. Back up a little bit. Alright. I'm gonna push A, which I got it programmed to D-pad down. Are you getting it? Yes. Okay. Sorry if I'm long-winded. So let's start by doing loading the game up. So you may ask, why am I doing this video? It's because I talk to friends, even talk to people in the, at GameStop that I go see. And, wait a minute, let me get out of this and quit the mission right now. So you can see. The reason I'm doing this is because I'm getting tired of looking at my Xbox One and not being able to play it. It sucks, you know. And I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one. So let's see. On this controller, or really, on this controller over here, the Xbox One controller, which is the same thing, you would definitely to do the running, free running, you would have to push you would have to push right trigger and B at the same time to get into run and jump. What I've done, and I can show you right now. Okay, let me turn it on. Okay. Let's just say I take square on my controller and I push back here. The right trigger, which is R2 on mine.
You cleaned up the audio I sent.
Now look, as you can see, I'm running, but I cannot vault.
This is good. I'll run a search on his workplace.
Thanks.
There. Nikki's there. I know it.
Okay. Now look. This is what I'm doing. And watch my fingers if you want to. I'm basically holding the R trigger to my square, and I'm running just with two fingers. The problem is when I get to running after somebody, I have to do this, like this. Look, you start right here, up here, you start. I had to push B, and they're still got it. The guy is getting away because I'm having to push that button because I can't hold the running button and push B. Now, if you take a look, I'm going to program this now. Square, I'm going to do it again. And the light blinking, telling me he's ready. I got my index finger on the B and my middle finger on the trigger. I push both of them at the same time. I got it programmed. Now let's see what it does. Flawless. And if you want to see it again, while I push the button, doing it here. Same button I was pushing before, just to run. But now running in. Doing the jump. Same thing that goes with shooting. If I had to shoot, which is hard to do because I would have to use the right trigger and to shoot and the left trigger to aim. Luckily, all I had to do is take. I took where the Y is, programmed it, push the... Put just the aim.
Oh, shit.
Right there. And now I can shoot with the trigger button.
911, what's your emergency?
I just saw someone pull out a gun. You have to send help.
Hello, are you still there? Hello?
And as you can see, I bought it, but I had to push. So you see me running. Believe me, I'm not the best when it comes to shooters, but I can get the job done, especially when I'm playing as a sniper. Love it. But the point that I'm trying to make here is that Xbox and Sony both need to come up with some controller that would not only benefit me and benefit other people like myself, or just the populace in general, that they want, that will let us, allow us to play the new systems and beyond. Because I guarantee you there are little kids, teenagers, that either is in the same position or not, or, and worse, and they like playing games, but it's hard when the companies does not seem to take this into consideration. Yes, I know it may not be in demand, and it may not be popular, but I guarantee you, like myself, you make controllers like this, we'll go buy them, and we'll go buy many of them just to have, so if one breaks, we will have another one to keep going. Now, let me put this down. Or try to. Let me change the TV. Excuse me. I'm getting the Xbox One control. Now, let me just show you the difference of what I'm talking about. Yes, the Xbox One is beautiful, and the graphics are beautiful. But it's beside the point. Just because it's beautiful does not mean that I can play games. There's certain games I can play, like Madden Football. But of course, anybody knows like me with Madden Football, they have not changed the control scheme much at all. So yes, all I got to do is use A to throw, Y to catch, or B to do. And most of the time, you can let the computer do it for you. So when you hack the ball through it, if you threw it in the right direction, the receiver will catch it. And then running, you just make, all you gotta do is push the left analog stick. And you're good to go, right? So, but games like Watch Dogs, Halo, business, shooter games, even racing games, I play on my 360 that I could take the right trigger and put it over to one of the face buttons, and I could drive. Luckily, I'm not the best driver when it comes to driving games, but that's besides the point. My whole mission and my plea to is that someone from Xbox and Sony will see this and say, he may have a point. And like I said, it's not just for me or someone like myself. This can go towards all gamers. Because that way, the game developers don't have to keep putting in the option, you know, like in Halo or Call of Duty, do you want Scheme 1 or do you want Scheme 2 where you can honestly switch to left hand or right hand, you know, where the triggers are with the controller like that, you could just put where your buttons go. So if you're a lefty and you need the trigger button right here, see? The trigger button right here. You need the trigger button to be on the left side, but the game don't allow it. On that controller, you could just program and put it over to the left side. Duh. Simple as that. But let me show you real quick on what I'm talking about. And then I'm going to have my friend take out this system and put it into the USB port. And I will show you that it does not want to recognize it. Funny thing was, I thought it was software. I have a computer that has USB 3.0 connection. I put this into the 3.0 connection and it worked flawlessly. So it's the software inside the Xbox One, and I know in the PlayStation 4 that it's not causing it to be. But with me saying that, I'm not saying I need an upgrade. I'm saying there needs to be a new controller, because these right here, you cannot buy these in the store. If you go on eBay, oh my God, it's like searching for a needle on a haystack. And when you do find them, you try to buy them as much as you can. But they do not make those controllers. So either Xbox needs to get with someone, and Sony also, at the market, and they need to put out a controller like this. And what it needs to have is not just every button programmable, but rapid fire will help us also. That way you don't have to keep pushing the button, it will just, you can just hold it and it will fire. Now, sorry, I'm taking so long, but I'm waiting on this game to load. On the Xbox One. But I wanted to show the difference of what you saw me play and watch me try to play Watch Dogs on Xbox One. I like Watch Dogs. I was looking forward to it. It's a fun game. I know a lot of people criticize it, but you take games for what they are. You know, and if you're going to criticize a game because it don't fit your style of play or they hyped it up, then why are you playing games? We all know as gamers that they hype up or the one they don't like, but really good. So, here we go. We got the first mission, which is not very hard, but now, you're telling me to hold aim and to shoot. Now, watch me try to do this. How in the heck? Okay, I got the aim. Now, I gotta try to maneuver my thumb, or matter of fact, I can't even get to the right analog, the analog stick. I'm trying. I do a pinky. Okay. Now look at the screen. Look at the screen. I finally got up there. I had to push it with my leg to do it. Now, this one's easy because I just had to push B. But as you can see, if that me in a gunfight, I'll be there all the time. Still recording. So, and of course, with the X button, I can do the X, but imagine me trying to drive and do all that. So, give me a few minutes. I'm gonna take this cord out. I don't know why my light went off, but it did. I'm gonna take this cord out and I'm gonna have my friend put it in place of the Xbox One over there.